Okay, sir, let's start. So welcome all the learners to OSU online class. So we have been teaching through online since last 2 months so far because of this COVID-19 crisis, and it is a critical juncture for all the academic and the universities and every part of the world to be a part in the online class process. So today we are having with us Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra. Again, we don't need to introduce him. Like, he has been teaching with us, or he has been associated with us in this teaching process, online teaching process, since long time, since last two months. So today he will be teaching on a different topic. Like, he generally prefer to teach the theoretical part of the political theory and the theoretical part of political science. But today he will be touch upon the very interesting area of political science. The paper is called Peace and Conflict Studies of MPS 12. So basically, today he will touch upon the first two units of this paper. And the first two units of this paper is like Peace and Conflict Studies, Nature and Scope. And second unit, he will be touch upon conceptual analysis of peace and conflict. So basically, when we start this class, I want to briefly introduce how the peace and conflict studies is so much relevant in the contemporary situation in the political science. So peace and conflict studies, as we know, like, the conflict is a inherent, so it is a natural process in the society, a natural process in the state. So when we are talking about the state, the conflict in the state means there are different aspects of conflict which is exist in the state or exist in the world. And now there is conflict in the world, there is conflict within the state, there is conflict between the states. But what are the major challenges, or what are the major institutions are working on to resolve the conflict? And what are the process, what are the methods, what are the different aspects, what are different approach of the state are adopting to solve the conflict, are adopting to resolve the conflict of two state or within society or within the different civilizations, as you can see. So today, Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra will touch upon what is the nature of conflict, what are the nature of conflict, and what is the scope of conflict. What are the nature of conflict means, what are the area, the state, the society, it really need to focus and really face challenge in terms of creating any type of conflict. So without any wasting time, I will request Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra to deliver his lecture. And I also request all the learners, please mute your mic during this session, or don't present anything in the screen, because it will create disturbance for you, for speaker, for me, or for technical support. So please mute your mic. We'll give opportunity to speak with our speaker by putting your question in the chat box. We can answer whatever you have asked. So now I would request Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra to deliver his lecture. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Antarjami. Good morning, all of you. And today, the course is a new course for me also, Peace and Conflict Studies, Conflict or Peace Studies. And let me say also, in my MA also, this paper I did not opted for. But after going through the materials, what is there in your website, that Antarjami, you can also handle this course. I mean, for this course, the earlier knowledge will help you. If you have, you know, understanding of political theory, thought philosophy, then you can understand it. Two chapters, you know, teaching two units in one class, it's always very difficult. So that means I will speak on some, and I will not speak on some aspect of first and second unit. What is important? The important is to understand what we are reading. So what I will not speak, It is also relevant. Once you will go through your materials, you will understand. And if you will have any problem with that material, then we can also, look into various literatures that whether the materials are right or materials are wrong. So let me begin. What is peace? What is peace? Basically, peace means we understand peace is the absence of non-peace. Peace is the absence of non-peace. So what is non-peace? Something which is not peace. Something which is a violence. Something which is a manifested violence. जो violence टा में देखी पड़ जो, right? A violence what we can see, what we can observe, what we can sense, that is manifest violence. So peace is the absence of manifest violence, and there are several other connotation of peace. For example, respite from war. Respite means postponing the war. Then it is quiet from disorder, right? Rest from any compunction. Compunction means a state of confused and noisy disturbance, right? I mean, if you are not confused, if you are not disturbed, then you are in the mood of peace, right? So tumhe jodi confused rahila, tumhe jodi disturbed rahila, then you are not in the peace of mind. And also some can also say peace is the freedom from terror. Terror means terrorizing some person, doreba. So peace means, I mean, if you are a peaceful person, then neither you will terrorize people nor you will fear others. Tamane mu kahaku dorebini ki kahaku mu dorebini. Jodi mu doruchi ba doruchi, then my state of mind is not peace. Peace means silence. The moment you speak, your mind works. And when your mind works, you speak, then you are not in a peace of mind. When you will be in peace of mind? Now when you will be silent. Sethipai loko mane dhyana karithanti, dhyana kala bale kichu katha barta karanti ni. Silence through the one can also gain the peace. So peace, in other words, known as silence also. And last one, the peace is the suppression of thought. That is very important. And for me, this is a very fascinating aspect of peace. Thought. The moment you think, then you are not in a peace of mind. One thought leads to another thought. Then once you are thinking, then you are knowing that that thinking is dangerous. You are losing your peace of mind with the thinking. Sometimes we intellectuals call that ignorance is the bliss. Bliss means what? Ashirvad. Kahiki na ignorance amku shanti dauchi, but jatala ame gote jinso ku chinta karuche, poduche, bujhiba pai chesta karuche, then we lose our mental balance, and we become confused, and we lose our peace. So the concept of peace, it is derived from the human nature. There are three views on human nature. The first view of human nature is that human nature is essentially good and peaceful. All right. So you can see the qualities like altruism. Altruism means what? Doing good to others. It is an attitude. Altruism is an attitude of doing good to others. So qualities like altruism, sympathy for others in the distress, pity for the suffering fellow, etc. Right? ইভেন তুমি তোমার লাইফরে বি তুমি এটা ফিল করিথিব ইউ নো হোয়েন ইউ ডু সমথিং গুড ফর অদর্স দেন ইউ ফিল রিল্যাক্সড অ্যান্ড ইউ ফিল দ্যাট ইউ নো ইউ ফিল পিস ইনসাইড ইউ হ্যাঁ যেতবে তুমি কাহা পাই কিছু গোটে করুছ যেতবে জন অসুবিধার পড়ুছি দেন ইউ আর নট বিকমিং হার্শ টু অদর রাদার দেন ইউ বিকম ভেরি মচ সিম্পাথেটিক টু 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 those who are in a very distressful you know situation you are also showing your pityness towards those who are suffering so all these qualities that is something natural to the human being so this notion have a very strong link to the role of ethical spirit that amane kana কি এতে যে আমি কোয়ালিটিজ গুড়া কহিলু কোণ যেমতি অল্ট্রুইজম কোয়ালিটি কহিলু সিম্পাথি কোয়ালিটি কহিলু পিটিনেস কোয়ালিটি কহিলু অল দিস কোয়ালিটিজ আর ন্যাচুরাল টু হ্যুম্যান বিংস আমি এটা কি শিখাও কি ন শিখাও গোটে গোটে ছোট পিলাকে তুমি অবজর্ভ কর দেখ তা ভিতরে বি এইসব গুণ গুড়া ন্যাচুরালি থাকে And, jointa me naturally prapto kari thao, that has a very strong connection with the ethics. I mean, we are born good, we are born with virtue. And if you remember, you know, Locke or Rousseau, you can understand that how the state of nature, you know, made the life or Hobbes, for example, you can take also Hobbes. The nasty, brutish sort, the human nature in the Hobbesian state of nature was nasty, brutish sort. And similar kind of, you know, human nature in the Lockean philosophy, it is better than the Hobbes. And in also Rousseau, it is also better than the Hobbes. But there are certain tendencies you can find the Hobbesian, Lockean and the Rousseau concept of human nature that you know, with the, you know, introduction of certain kind of, you know, society, but certain kind of, you know, gathering community, you know, individual, they become bad, right? So it basically means that by nature, individuals are good. And when I'm saying individuals are good, they are having the ethical spirit within their personality. And this theory is called ethical humanism or rational humanism. So the past view of human nature, it speaks that that human natures are basically or naturally they are good, they are having ethical spirit attached to them, right? And the second view, it holds that human you know nature is basically essentially it is bad and aggressive. You can take the example of Darwin and his evolution theory. So to Darwin, the role of aggression is a necessary aspect of the evolution of living species. The role of aggression, tamane if remember the Three Idiots movie and remember the introductory talk professor, right? And he gave a very good example. Life begins with the murder, right? If you want to live, then you cannot live with the existence of other. I mean, you can only live when you are killing. Actually, you are killing the other. Your existence depends on the killing. If the other one will exist, then you may face certain existential problem. If you remember the movie, you can understand. So this is basically guided by the Darwin evolutionary theory. So to Darwin, the role of aggression is a necessary aspect of the evolution of living species by which some survive and some perish. তাৰমানে কিছু লোক সৰ্ভাইভ কৰিব কিছু লোক পেৰিছ কৰিব ষ্ট্ৰগল ফৰ এক্সিষ্টেন্স এণ্ড ছাৰ্ভাইভাল অফ দি ফিটেষ্ট আই মিন ষ্ট্ৰগল মিনছ ৱাট ষ্ট্ৰগল মিনছ ইউ আৰ ষ্ট্ৰগলিং ইউ আৰ প্লেয়িং উইথ ইয়াৰ এগ্ৰেশ্যন ৰাইট ইউ আৰ ষ্ট্ৰগলিং টু ছাৰ্ভাইভ So aggression is a given condition in all the evolution. Jetiki bhi evolutionary theorist asanti, semane they take aggression as a accepted condition or as a given condition. To evolutionary theory, animal nature of man is the reality. There is also another aspect. That ame kahuche manusha bhitare animal quality achi, manusha bhitare rational quality achi. No individual is 100% rational, no individual is 100% animal also. But the degree of animality and rationality, it may differ. If the person is guided more on rationality than animality, then that person will be different. From that person who is guided by the mostly guided by the animal quality. So basically, if you see that we individuals, especially I'm talking about the middle class individual or individual in a broader sense. I'm not talking about those yogis and mahayogis. I'm not talking about them. But any normal individual, for them. Animality is a very important aspect with his or her personality. In fact, without animal quality, we cannot live. We can take the example of sex as a kind of animal quality, right? So without sex also, the human existence will lose its presence on this earth. So that maybe the sex has a rational role to play, but sex itself is a animal quality. So hence, the idea of human nature is integrally related to the problem of the existence of peace-oriented oriented conduct. I mean, if you want to live in peace, then you have to struggle, right? So if you want to exist, then your existence is actually is being considered as a problem of the existence of peace-oriented conduct. So your existence is actually non-peace. If you will follow the principle of peace, then you may not exist. You may perish. So to exist, you have to go against the peace, you have to think about your survival, and you have to move on. All right. So there are thinkers who hold that violence is not only natural, but also moral. Right? So, jatala ame Darwin katha kouche, satale laguchi, violence is something which is natural to human being, natural to their existence, but violence is also, it is not only natural, but also it is moral. Violence hoba uchit. It is moral because it is related to the concept of good and evil, question of morality and immorality. That means, remember the Mahabharata. All about, it's actually a violence. But why that violence happened? Why, when Arjuna asked Krishna that if you know that such destruction will happen, why you allowed this violence to happen? And there is a very, very sensible reply from Lord Krishna that what he said, that the violence is necessary. He gave a moral justification for Mahabharata. What is that moral justification? That it is through Mahabharata one can understand whether war is good or bad. It is through Mahabharata one can understand what is good and what is evil. Who are those Duryodhan in today's arena? Who are these Shakuni in today's arena? Who are these Dhritarashtra in today's arena? Who are Pitamaha Bhishma in today's arena? Who is Angaraj Karn? So all these characters, they are actually also there in our present day society. So Mahabharata It gave you a sense through which you can judge who is who and what is good and what is bad, what is the right decision, what is the wrong decision, what is moral and what is immoral. So this is a very, you know, moral justification of Mahabharata given by, Lord Krishna. That you can take, it is a moral justification of the violence. And the third view of human nature is that human nature is transformed by social relationship, right? So what does it mean to this view? Human nature in the pure sense of individual nature is irrelevant. Why? Because the concept of human nature does not matter in the case of a person living alone. Right? She kahuchi kana, the concept of good, bad, ethical, unethical, moral, immoral, these are not the natural construction, or these are not the construction of individual initiative. Rather than, these are the social construction. Why social construction? Now, you could have a good example to tell. से कहला जदि तुम्हें कहो ह्यूमन नेचर टा होचो इंडिविजुअल नेचर आ इंडिविजुअल तार गोटे यूनिक नेचर थाए तेबे गोटे इंडिविजुअल को कौन करा जाओ ना ताकू गोटे पर्टिकुलर जगह रे आमे गोटे लोक को आमे बंदी करके रखी दऊ से सोसाइटी सत्र मिसी पारिबो नाही गोटे पिला को आमे आरंभ रु नो 20 वर्ष पर्यंत ताकू आमे सोसाइटी थारु दूर रे रखिबो से का सत्र मिसिबोनी मिसी पारिबोनी से आफ्टर 20 इयर्स तुम्हें देखिबो से लोक भितर कौन सी नेचर डेवलप है नथिबो से लोक भितर तुम्हें देखी परिवोनी कि वेदर दैट इंडिविजुअल इज बेड और गुड नाइदर यू कैन से दैट इंडिविजुअल इज गुड नॉर यू कैन से दैट इंडिविजुअल इज बैड सो इन दैट सिचुएशन द थर्ड व्यू ऑफ ह्यूमन नेचर इट होल्ड्स दैट गुड और बेड क्वालिटीज आर नॉट नेचुरल टू इंडिविजुअल And it is not individual to individual. It is individual theory karuni. But third view, she first view or second view could challenge karuchi. She kahuchi kan, rather than this good and bad qualities of individual, the moral and immoral qualities of individual, these are the consequence of social relationship. जेहेतु आमे सोसाइटी को आसिलु आमे सोसाइटी रे रहिलु नाउ समथिंग इज गुड एंड बेड नॉट इन इटसेल्फ बट व्हेन इट इज कॉन्टेक्चुअलाइज्ड इन अ कॉन्टेक्स्ट व्हेन इट इज कॉन्टेक्चुअलाइज्ड इन सोसाइटी देन द मीनिंग कम्स दैट इट इज गुड और इट इज नॉट गुड सो फ्रॉम दिस अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ ह्यूमन नेचर वन मे अंडरस्टैंड द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ पीस केमिति ना थर्ड व्यू रे सोसाइटी नीड्स पीस सोसाइटी को सदा बेले पीस दरकार तेणु इंडिविजुअल नो अबाउट पीस फ्रॉम द सोसाइटी इन द थर्ड व्यू इन द सेकंड व्यू इंडिविजुअल नोज अबाउट पीस बाय गोइंग थ्रू द वायलेंस बिकॉज थ्रू द वायलेंस इंडिविजुअल अंडरस्टैंड द प्राइस ऑफ पीस एंड द कॉस्ट ऑफ वायलेंस जोटा आम महाभारत आम एग्जाम्पल दौचे रईट आम जिते कहे भायोलेंस इज नेचुरल सेत आम गोटे जिनस उपलब्धि करूचे इफ आई हैव टू किल यू फॉर माय एक्जिस्टेंस कैन आई गेट हैप्पीनेस आफ्टर किलिंग यू वी ऑल्सो आस्क दिस क्वेश्चन टू द सेकेंड व्यू ऑफ ह्यूमन नेचर माने जदि मो पड़ोसी माने खाइबा पई ए कोरोना टाइम रे कोविड 19 ले जदि मो पड़ोसी खाइबा पई पाऊ नाही तबे मु कोन भलो खाद्य खाई की खुशी हेई परिबे की जतले मो पड़ोसी टे मरिबा मरि जाउची वा मरिबा को जाउची सेते बेले मु कोन बंची छी बोली खुशी हेई परिबे की नाउ वी अंडरस्टैंड द एसेंस ऑफ पीस विद द एक्जिस्टेंस ऑफ अदर राइट वी आर चैलेंजिंग द इवोल्यूशनरी थ्योरी ऑफ डार्विन And in the first view also, we do understand there are also qualities that is something innate to our personality. So almost all these three views of human nature, it gives a clarification that peace is very much significant for human existence. If you are not in the peace of mind, then you are a danger for human existence. Now, when we are saying that peacemaking, what does it mean? When we are saying that peacemaking, it means that conflict resolution or resolving a conflict without the violence. Violence may be physical, violence may be non-physical. Violence basically means hurting others. You should try first not to hurt any individual physically or non-physically, and by not hurting, you are trying to resolve a conflict. So the basic assumption of peace is that kahinki peace darkar ba, what is the justification of peace? Now, war is neither a natural phenomena nor a irreversible will of God. Kona, what is the basic assumption of peace? Se kahuchi ki war, ami jo juddho karuchu, war is not something which is given to us naturally. Right? It is not the will of God. Ame war kahinki karuchu? Now it is actually the human greedy that pushes us towards the war. So a peaceful world belongs to society. Bhagavan kebe bhi judhya katha koi nahi. Mahabharata judhya pare bhi Bhagavan, Lord Krishna ita kahi tile. Now, human being will not try for second Mahabharata. Kaunasi jinsa srushti hai na thai. Judhya re sabu jinsa binas hai thai. Dui pakhyuri binas hai thai judhya. Tanu judhya ta kebe bhi society paying gote virtue nuho, judhyata, ba violence, ba conflict, it is the vice for the society. So a peaceful world belongs to the society. Society paying peaceful world darkar, society paying violent world darkar nuho. And a peaceful world means what? A peaceful world is a world where the working people working and living together in harmony and friendship. My existence will not cause negativity for your existence. Rather than your existence will be the strength of my existence. Just remember the spirit of Gandhian philosophy. Gandhi believed in it. So peace demand two things. Peace demand spiritualism at individual level, and socialism or social justice at social level. That means you cannot hold peace if you are not spiritual. If you are material, then jee bhi material, jaharo mind material, se kebe bhi jibon le sukha prapto kari na tha. Tenu, peace at individual level is nothing but spiritualism. Spiritualism means what? When you are going above than yourself. Toko ame salvation kahi paribu. When you are seeing the other in yourself, and when you are seeing yourself in the other, me tujhme hu aur tu mujhme hai, the realization of it is actually the spiritualism. So if you are not spiritual, then individual level you cannot get or you cannot earn peace. At the social level, socialism or the social justice is actually peace. Khali individual level le tame khali peace hele hobani. Even dharma, actually dharma is not individual in nature. Dharma, the concept of dharma is always social in nature. You may be good, but what goodness you have given to the society, that evaluate whether you are a righteous person or not. So peace demands spiritualism at individual level, and peace demands social justice at social level. You can take the example of Gautam Buddha. Gautam Buddha, we can take Gautam Buddha as a ambassador of peace. Buddham saranam gacchami, sangham saranam gacchami. What does it mean? When you are saying Buddham saranam gacchami, then you are, you know, surrendering your all pain and pleasure to Buddha, to Almighty. And you will be, you know, free from this worldly pain, you know, pain and pleasure. Once you go beyond the pain and pleasure, then you can generate certain social justice within you. And when you generate certain social justice within you, it will spill over to the society. So look at, you know, Buddhism. You can find that is the concept of justice, that is the concept of equality, that is the concept of non-violence, that is the concept of inner peace, that is the concept of compassion. You are compassionate. But you are not, you know, much more rigid about the wrong things. Actually, I am also rigid about the wrong things. I don't have that compassion attitude within me. It is my self-reflection also. And you can also reflect ki how to develop compassion. If you don't have compassion, daya au khyama, jadi tuma personality re part no ho, jadi tume janaku khyama na kari parcha, to khyama, I mean, gote bapote puo ko karibo, puo te bapo karibo, bohute sasu ko karibo, sasute bohutu karibo, jadi family bhitire compassion nahi, daya khyama nahi, jodi family bhitre gote concept of equality nahi, jodi family bhitre gote concept of justice nahi, jodi family bhitre gote concept of non-violence nahi, tebe se family re kebe bi peace sambhav hebo nahi. Peace is not possible in that family. So peace is related with the existential harmony. Kahi ki peace darkar? What is the relevance of peace? Now peace is necessary for our existence. आमे जदि पीसफुल आमे न रहिबो देन आमर आयुष भी हानि घटिजिबो. आमे सदाबेले चिंता रे रहिबो, सदाबेले चिंता करिबाटा देह पई भलो भी हेइ नथा. तेनो पीस इज नेसेसरी फॉर द एक्जिस्टेंस ऑफ इंडिविजुअल एंड फॉर द एक्जिस्टेंस ऑफ सोसाइटी. इफ सोसाइटी विल बी गाइडेड बाय द कांसेप्ट ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस, देन द लॉन्गजीविटी of the society, it will go on and it will move on. Even in the you know, that there is also another aspect, that peace is related with the existential harmony, as I said before, rather than conquering the earth. That is very important, right? If individual wants, jodi manisha chahibo ki peaceful atmosphere rahiba pai manisha rahi paribo, किंतु मनीष रही पारुनी कहीं ना मनीष चिंता करुचि बा चेष्टा करुचि टू कंकर दि वर्ल्ड वर्ल्डली प्लेजर मु सब जिनस को अचीव करी मोर पिला माने ब्रिलियंट हेबे मु समस्तन थारु गोटे पाद आगरे रहिबे. ई एटीट्यूड उडा कोन ई एटीट्यूड होचे कंकरिंग दि वर्ल्ड इन दि नेम ऑफ एक्जिस्टेंस. तांकु जदि पचारा जीव से माने कोन कहिबे ना एगुडा तो आजिकल समस्ते करुचंति तेनु आमको करबा पई पडिबो. आमे जदि न करि परबा आमेटा एक्जिस्ट करि परबानी. बट द जस्टिफिकेशन दे आर गिविंग इन दि नेम ऑफ एक्जिस्टेंस, इन रियलिटी दे आर गोइंग अगेंस्ट द लॉजिक और फिलोसॉफी ऑफ एक्जिस्टेंस. एंड व्हाट इज द फिलोसॉफी ऑफ एक्जिस्टेंस? फिलोसॉफी ऑफ एक्जिस्टेंस टेल्स अस दैट प्लीज do not try to conquer the world. Please, for the God's sake, do not, you know, be, or don't be guided by your greed. Rather than, stay with harmony with others. Stay with harmony. Stay with others. Jonta ame COVID-19 samay re bi government bi seita amaro prachar karuche. Tume rogo ko ghruna kara, rogi ki ghruna kara. But ame society re taro ulta ta ame dekhuche. लोक रोग को डरी की रोगी को घृणा करिवारे लागी जाउछ. इन द एनलाइटनमेंट थिंकिंग आल्सो वायलेंस एंड कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स आर सीन इन द ग्रेटेस्ट इविल. କୌଣସି ବି ୟୁ ନୋ ଇଭିନ୍ ମହାଭାରତରେ ବି ଯେଉଁ ଯୁଦ୍ଧଟା ହେଲା ଲାଷ୍ଟରେ ବି ମହାଭାରତରେ କୃଷ୍ଣ କହିଲେ ଯୁଦ୍ଧ ଭଲ ନୁହଁ, ଯୁଦ୍ଧରୁ ମଣିଷ ଶିଖିବା ଉଚିତ କି ଯୁଦ୍ଧ କେତେ ଭୟାନକ, ଯୁଦ୍ଧ କେମିତି ମଣିଷର ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସକୁ ଡିସମାଣ୍ଟଲ କରେଇ ଦେଉଛି, ରାଇଟ୍? ଇଭିନ୍ ୟୁ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ଗୋ ଥ୍ରୁ ଜନ୍ ଲକ୍ ଅର୍ ରୁସ, ଫର୍ ଦେମ୍ ଦ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ନେଚର there was problem. And what was the problem in the state of nature? In the state of nature, peace was not there. Nobody, no institution or organization was there in the state of nature to ensure peace. And that's why in their contractual theory, both Rousseau and Locke, they talked about the civil society, they talked about the state, they talked about the government, they talked about the general will. So all these institutions that will ensure peace in the state of nature. So when I'm saying peace, peace means there is justice, peace means there is equality, peace means there is compassion, peace means there is non-violence. So Rousseau and Locke, they are the liberals. ଲିବରାଲ୍ସକୁ ଛାଡ଼ିଲା ପରେ ବି ଯେଉଁମାନେ ଏନାର୍କିଷ୍ଟ ଲାଇକ୍ ଟଲଷ୍ଟୟ, ମାର୍କ୍ସିଷ୍ଟ, ୟୁ ନୋ, ସେମାନେ ବି ଦେ କନ୍ସିଡର୍ ପିସ୍ ଏଜ୍ ଦି ଚେରିଷ୍ଡ ଭ୍ୟାଲ୍ୟୁ ଅଫ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଚେରିଷ୍ଡ ହ୍ୟୁମାନ୍ ଭ୍ୟାଲ୍ୟୁ, ରାଇଟ୍? ମାର୍କ୍ସିଷ୍ଟ ଆଉ ଏନାର୍କିଷ୍ଟ ମାନେ ବି ପିସ୍କୁ ଗୁରୁତ୍ୱ ଦେଇଛନ୍ତି କି ହାଉ ଟୁ ଏଚିଭ୍ ପିସ୍. ଲିବରାଲ୍ସ ମାନେ କହିଲେ ବାଇ ଏଷ୍ଟାବ୍ଲିଶିଂ ଇନଷ୍ଟିଟ୍ୟୁସନ୍ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଗେଟ୍ ପିସ୍. ବଟ୍ ମାର୍କ୍ସିଷ୍ଟ ଆଉ ଏନାର୍କିଷ୍ଟ ସେମାନେ କହିଲେ ଇନଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନ୍ ଆର୍ ଦି ସୋର୍ସ ଅଫ୍ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ସୋର୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଭାଇଲେନ୍ସ. ଓନ୍ଲି ୱେନ୍ ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ଡିସମାଣ୍ଟଲ୍ ଦି ଇନଷ୍ଟିଚ୍ୟୁସନ୍, ମାର୍କ୍ସ ଯେଉଁଟା କହିଲେ, ଓନ୍ଲି ୱେନ୍ ଦ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ୱିଦର୍ ଏୱେ ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଗେଟ୍ ଦି ପିସ୍. ସୋ ପିସ୍ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ବି ଏଚିଭ୍ ଟୁ ଏନାର୍କିଷ୍ଟ ଆଣ୍ଡ ମାର୍କ୍ସିଷ୍ଟ ଆଫ୍ଟର ଦି ଏବୋଲିସମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ପଲିଟିକାଲ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଚର୍, ହ୍ୱିଚ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ମେନ୍ କଜ୍ ଅଫ୍ ସୋସିଆଲ୍ ଅପ୍ରେସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏକ୍ସପ୍ଲୋଇଟେସନ୍. ଜଷ୍ଟ ଲିବରାଲକୁ ଅପୋଜ୍ କଲେ ଏନାର୍କିଷ୍ଟ ଆଉ ମାର୍କ୍ସିଷ୍ଟ, ବଟ୍ ତାଙ୍କର ଉଦ୍ଦେଶ୍ୟ କ'ଣ? ତାଙ୍କର ଉଦ୍ଦେଶ୍ୟ ସମାନ, ଲିବରାଲ ମାର୍କ୍ସିଷ୍ଟ ଏନାର୍କିଷ୍ଟ ତାଙ୍କର ଉଦ୍ଦେଶ୍ୟ ସମାନ. ଉଦ୍ଦେଶ୍ୟ ହେଉଛି କ'ଣ? ହାଉ ଟୁ ଗେଟ୍ ପିସ୍. ନାଓ ଲେଟ୍ ଅସ୍ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଟୁ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ନେଚର୍ ଅଫ୍ ପିସ୍. ଦ ଫାର୍ଷ୍ଟ, ପିସ୍ ଏଜ୍ ସୋସିଆଲ ହାର୍ମୋନି, ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦି ପିସ୍ ଏଜ୍ ଏଭଏଡେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଇଣ୍ଟରପର୍ସନାଲ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ. ହ୍ୱେନ୍ ଆଇ ଏମ୍ ସେଇଙ୍ଗ ପିସ୍ ଏଜ୍ ସୋସିଆଲ ହାର୍ମୋନି, that means peace is possible if there is harmony in the society. Harmony in the society, how that harmony in the society will be established? Now only when individual will do their dharma, do their duty before demanding right, they must perform their duty. And the duty of the individual, that is something given by the structure. Remember the Plato's concept of ideal state. You know, janithibo, you know, every individual personality have three kind of traits: reason, spirit, appetite. All individuals have reason, spirit, appetite. Kichinka bhitare reason adhika achi, kichinka bhitare spirit adhika achi, kichinka bhitare appetite adhika achi. Jomanka bhitare reason adhika achi, they become the philosopher king. ଯେଉଁମାନଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ସ୍ପିରିଟ୍ ଅଧିକା ଅଛି, ଦେ ବିକମ୍ ଦି ଅକ୍ଜୁଲାରୀ ଅର୍ ସୋଲଜର୍ ଅର୍ ଦି ଆର୍ମି. ଯେଉଁମାନଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଆପିଟାଇଟ୍ ଅଧିକା ଅଛି, ସେମାନେ ଦେ କନ୍ଷ୍ଟିଟ୍ୟୁଟ୍ ଦି ଆର୍ଟିଜାନ୍ କ୍ଲାସ୍ ଅର୍ ଦି ଫାର୍ମର୍, ଦେ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍, ଦେ ଆର୍ ଦି ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସିଂ କ୍ଲାସ୍. ସୋ ଅଲ୍ ଦିସ୍ କ୍ଲାସେସ୍, ଦେ ଆର୍ ନାଇଦର୍ ସୁପିରିୟର୍ ଅର୍ ଇନଫିରିୟର୍, ବଟ୍ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଦି ଥ୍ରୀ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ କ୍ଲାସେସ୍. ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦି ଥ୍ରୀ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ କ୍ଲାସେସ୍, ଦେ ହାଭ୍ ଥ୍ରୀ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ଫଙ୍କସନ୍ ଟୁ ପରଫର୍ମ. ତେଣୁ ଦେଶକୁ ରୁଲ୍ କିଏ କରିବ? ନା ଦେଶକୁ ରୁଲ୍ କରିବ ଫିଲୋସଫର କିଂ. କାହିଁକି? ନା ଦେ ନୋ ଦି ନଲେଜ୍, ଆଣ୍ଡ ଫର୍ ଗ୍ରୀକ୍ ନଲେଜ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଭାର୍ଚ୍ୟୁ. ଦେଶକୁ ଶାସନ କିଏ କରିବ? ନା ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି କ୍ଷତ୍ରିୟ, ବିକଜ୍ ଦେ ନୋ ଦି ଆର୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଡିଫେଣ୍ଡିଂ. ଆଉ ଦେଶକୁ ଇଣ୍ଟର୍ନାଲି କିଏ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରଙ୍ଗ କରିବ? ନା ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସିଂ କ୍ଲାସ୍ କରିବ. ଯଦି ସେମାନେ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ନ କରିବେ, ଦେଶ ୱିକ୍ ହେଇଯିବ, ଦେଶର ଇକୋନୋମି ୱିକ୍ ହେଇଯିବ. ତେଣୁ ଗୋଟେ ଦେଶର ଇଣ୍ଟେଲେକ୍ଚୁଆଲ ଫାଉଣ୍ଡେସନ୍ ଦରକାର, ଗୋଟେ ଦେଶର ମିଲିଟାରୀ ଫାଉଣ୍ଡେସନ ଦରକାର ଏଣ୍ଡ ଗୋଟେ ଦେଶର ୟୁନୋ ଇକୋନୋମିକ ଫାଉଣ୍ଡେସନ ଦରକାର ତେଣୁ ମୁଁ ଗୋଟେ ଦେଶର ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ପାଇଁ ବା ଗୋଟେ ଗୋଟେ ଦେଶର ଅର୍ଡର ବା ଗୋଟେ ଦେଶର ପିସ୍ ପାଇଁ ତିନିଟା ଜିନିଷ ବହୁତ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାଣ୍ଟ ଇଣ୍ଟେଲେକ୍ଚୁଆଲ ଫାଉଣ୍ଡେସନ ମିଲିଟାରୀ ଫାଉଣ୍ଡେସନ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଇକୋନୋମିକ ଫାଉଣ୍ଡେସନ ଇଫ୍ ସଚ୍ ଥିଙ୍ଗସ୍ ଆର୍ ଦେୟାର ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ଡ ଏ ଆଇଡିଆଲ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇନ୍ ଏ ଆଇଡିଆଲ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ପିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଏଭର୍ ପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟ ଫିନୋମେନା ଯଦି ଆଇଡିଆଲ ଷ୍ଟେଟ୍ ଅଛି ଯଦି ସେଇଟାରେ ଅର୍ଡର ରହିବ ଯିଏ ଯାହା କାମ କରିବ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଅଲ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ୍ସ ଆର୍ ଭେରି ମଚ୍ ଡ୍ୟୁଟି ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ଇଫ୍ ଆଇ ୱିଲ୍ ବି ଡ୍ୟୁଟି ସେଣ୍ଟ୍ରିକ୍ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ଗେଟ୍ ୟୁର ରାଇଟ୍ ରାଇଟ୍ ସୋ ୱେନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ୍ସ ଆର୍ ଭେରି ମଚ୍ ଡ୍ୟୁଟି କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ ଦେନ୍ ସୋସିଆଲ୍ ହାର୍ମୋନି ଇଜ୍ ଏଷ୍ଟାବ୍ଲିଶ୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ୱାନ୍ ସୋସିଆଲ୍ ହାର୍ମୋନି ଇଜ୍ ଏଷ୍ଟାବ୍ଲିଶ୍ଡ ଦେନ୍ ପିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଗିଫ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଦେଟ୍ ହାର୍ମୋନି ସୋ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ୱାଣ୍ଟ ପିସ୍ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ମେଣ୍ଟେନ୍ ୟୋର ସୋସିଆଲ୍ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ୟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ ମେଣ୍ଟେନ୍ ଦି ସୋସିଆଲ୍ ହାର୍ମୋନି ଦେଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ୱାନ୍ ନେଚର ଅଫ୍ ପିସ୍ ଦ ଅଦର ନେଚର ଅଫ୍ ପିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦଟ୍ ପିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଆନ୍ ଏଭଏଡେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଇଣ୍ଟର ପର୍ସନାଲ୍ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ଭାଲେନ୍ସ ପିସ୍ ମାନେ ରିମୁଭିଂ ଦ ଆଣ୍ଟାଗନିଷ୍ଟିକ୍ ଆଟିଟ୍ୟୁଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ୍ ପିସ୍ ସମଥିଙ୍ଗ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ରିଏଲାଇଜେସନ୍ ଦେଟ୍ ମାଇ ଏଙ୍ଗର ଇଜ୍ ମାଇ ଏନିମି peace is the realization of that I am there in my enemy and the enemy is also there inside me. Let's take the example of again Mahabharat. In the Mahabharat Kaurava mane Pandavanka upare bahut anyay karithile au even yuddhara sesa samaye madhya Pandavanka taraf ru Krishna shanti duta heki asithile shanti duta heki asiki raja ku se bujheithile ଆଉ ଲାଷ୍ଟରେ କହିଥିଲେ ତୁମେ ଏଇ ଛଅ ପାଞ୍ଚ ଜଣ ଯେଉଁ ପଞ୍ଚୁ ପାଣ୍ଡବ ଭାଇ ଅଛନ୍ତି ତାଙ୍କୁ ପାଞ୍ଚଟା ଗାଁ ଦିଆଯାଉ ପାଞ୍ଚଟା ଗାଁ ଦିଆଦେଲେ ଗାଁ ଦେଇଲେ ବି ଆମେ ପିସ୍କୁ ମେଣ୍ଟେନ୍ କରିବୁ ଆମେ ଯୁଦ୍ଧ କରିବୁନୁ ଭାଇମାନେ ପାଣ୍ଡବମାନେ ଭୁଲିଯିବେ କୌରବମାନେ ତାଙ୍କୁ କେତିକି ଯନ୍ତ୍ରଣା ଦେଇଛନ୍ତି ତେଣୁ କୃଷ୍ଣ ଗୋଟେ ଟ୍ରାଏ କରିଥିଲେ କୃଷ୍ଣ ଟ୍ରାଏଡ୍ to bring back peace and to bring between the Kaurava and Pandava. But unfortunately, it did not happen because the greed of Duryodhan was much more high. Aude khali greed na thila, gute ghruna bhi thila, gute hatredness thila. ଦୁର୍ଯ୍ୟୋଧନର ପାଣ୍ଡବଙ୍କ ପ୍ରତି ଗୋଟେ ହାଟ୍ରେଟନେସ୍ ଥିଲା ଏଇ ଦୁଇଟା ରିଜିନ୍ ପାଇଁ ୟୁ ନୋ ସେ ପିସ୍ଟା ପସିବୁଲ୍ ହେଇପାରିନଥିଲା ବଟ୍ ଡେଫିନେଟଲି କ୍ରିଷ୍ଣା ଟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଆଟେମ୍ପ୍ଟ ଟୁ 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 ଡିସମାଣ୍ଟଲ୍ ଦି ଡିଟରୁଏଟେଡ୍ ରିଲେସନ୍ ବିଟୱିନ୍ ଦି କୌରବ ଆଣ୍ଡ ପାଣ୍ଡବ ବିଫୋର୍ ଦି ଏମର୍ଜେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ମହାଭାରତ ୱାର୍ ଫର୍ ଦି ଏଷ୍ଟାବ୍ଲିଶମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ପିସ୍ ତେଣୁ କୃଷ୍ଣ ଗୋଟେ ଆଟେମ୍ପ୍ ନେଇଥିଲେ ଇଣ୍ଟରପର୍ସନାଲ ରିଲେସନ୍ ଥିଲା ଯେଉଁ କୌରବ ଆଉ ପାଣ୍ଡବଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ତାକୁ ୟୁ ନୋ ଡିସମାଣ୍ଟଲ୍ କରିବା ତାକୁ ପୁନଃ ଗୋଟେ ସ୍ଥାପନ ସମ୍ପର୍କକୁ ସ୍ଥାପନ କରିବା ପାଇଁ କୃଷ୍ଣ ଶେଷରେ ଗୋଟେ ଶାନ୍ତି ଦୂତ ହେଇକି ମଧ୍ୟ ଆସିଥିଲେ ନା ୟୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ସି ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଟୁ ଅଣ୍ଡରଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡିଂ ଅଫ୍ ପିସ୍ ପିସ୍ ଏଜ୍ ସୋସିଆଲ୍ ହାର୍ମୋନି ଆଣ୍ଡ ପିସ୍ ଏଜ୍ avoidance of violence krishna kahi ki 6 ta ga magitile krishna chahutule at least e 6 ta ga bi mili gale mahabharata yuddha re jo ete dhangsa heichi se dhangsa ru amku rakha mili jibo 6 ta ga nei ki pandav mane khushi re rahibe shanti bahut important nyay kintu nyay demand kartula kon ଜଷ୍ଟିସ୍ ଡିମାଣ୍ଡ କରୁଥିଲା କି ପାଣ୍ଡବମାନେ କୌରବଙ୍କୁ ଆଟାକ୍ କରିବା କଥା ପାଣ୍ଡବମାନେ ତାଙ୍କ ଅଧିକାରକୁ ଆଣିବା ଏଇଟା ଥିଲା ଜଷ୍ଟିସ୍ର ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ଦି କଲ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଜଷ୍ଟିସ୍ ବଟ୍ କୃଷ୍ଣ କ'ଣ କଲେ ନା କୃଷ୍ଣ ଗେଭ୍ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟାନ୍ସ ଟୁ ପିସ୍ ଓଭର୍ ଦି ଜଷ୍ଟିସ୍ କୃଷ୍ଣ ଚାହିଁଲେ କି ନ୍ୟାୟ ଠାରୁ ଶାନ୍ତି ମୂଲ୍ୟବାନ ଯଦି ଶାନ୍ତି ନ ରହିବ ତେବେ ହ୍ୟୁମେନ୍ ହିଁ ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟ କରିବନି ଆଉ ଯଦି ମଣିଷ ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟ ନ କରିବ ଦେନ୍ ଦ କନ୍ସେପ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଜଷ୍ଟିସ୍ ବିକମ୍ସ ଇରେଲିଭାଣ୍ଟ So from this two nature of peace, one can understand that there are two categories of peace. One is the negative peace and one is the positive peace. So there has been disagreement as to what constitute peace and violence. There are major debates between two groups. The group which holds peace as the absence of war, and when I'm saying peace as the absence of war, it means it is the negative peace. And there is another group, it holds peace is the absence of war plus presence of socio-economic justice. Tanu prathama group ta kahila peace hauchi absence of war. Ditiya group kahila kana na peace hauchi absence of war plus socio-economic justice. Tanu first group ta hala negative peace, second group ta hala kana na positive peace. Now this negative peace could be realized through negotiation and mediation. It recommends the use of non-violent means, total disarmament, and socio-economic interdependence. Right? So negative peace kon kahuchi? Negative peace does not talk about changing the base, changing the structure. Rather, the negative peace talks about jemti ki ame gote example nahi pariba. Suppose right now marginalized communities semane strike karuchanti. Tenu jo mane those who are the supporter of negative peace semane kon kahibe ki state a marginalized community loko jo mane strike karuchanti tanko upare state violence use kariba kotha nuha. Ta sahita eita bi kahibe ki jo mane strike karuchanti semane bi state against re violence यूज करिबा कथा नुह ता माने कोन ता नेगेटिव पी नेगेटिव पीस इट सपोर्ट्स ए काइंड ऑफ स्टेटस क्यू सपोर्ट्स ए काइंड ऑफ स्टेटस क्यू इट डजंट टॉक अबाउट टू 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 चेंज द स्ट्रक्चरल वायलेंस एज ए कांसेप्ट आई विल कम टू दैट सो दिस नेगेटिव पीस is very much status quo oriented, but the positive peace, positive peace, it means removing that structural violence. The struggle, the positive peace talks about removing structural violence. So it is not possible without an egalitarian social structure. To establish an egalitarian social structure, there is a need of eliminating an inegalitarian social structure. So that is the argument of positive peace. Then, as I said, negative peace is compatible with structural violence, but positive peace is not compatible with the structural violence. Positive peace kon kahuchi ki positive peace is actually negative peace plus what negative peace talks, positive peace talks it, but positive peace it talks more than what negative peace talks. And what is the what is that plus or what is that more? Now that more is dismantling the inegalitarian social structure, removing the structural violence. Right? What is the structural violence? You remember the case of Rohit Bimula. You know, there are the non-BJP forces. They perceive the suicide of Rohit Bimula as the result of structural violence. They even claim that it is the institutional murder. However, I don't buy that argument, but they perceive it. Now let me take another example of Three Idiots. When that engineering student, he commits suicide, then the hero Amir Khan, he went to the principal and he very bravely said that, sir, it is not suicide, sir, it is murder. It is a structural murder, right? The suicide is based on a kind of violence, and that violence is the structural violence. So we see that the the negative piece, it justifies the order, stability maintained by an oppressive system. And the positive piece, it just opposes to this aspect of the negative piece. It tries to change. ये change करीबा पहिं चाहूँची कौन ना उड़े जो structural violence अच्छी, right? उड़े invisible force अच्छी, जो invisible force मनुष्य को suicide करीबा पहिं बाध्य करुँची. से invisible force को a positive piece challenge करुँची. आमे example अबे भी नहीं परीबा. Now with this neoliberal economy, there is a huge changes in the relationship. Now both male and female they are committing suicide. The father is killing the son. The son is killing the father. And why it happens? Sometimes the wife is taking the help of her lover to murder the husband. The husband is also doing the same thing against the wife. Why there is so much of problem in the cry of it's because of certain structure. And what is that structure? Now that structure is the neoliberal economy. And once you are guided by the neoliberal economy, then it is an obvious fact that you will not understand that money cannot buy everything. Now you make yourself convinced that money is everything. So for positive peace, equality is an essential value because its absence perpetuates tension of all types. As long as equality is not there, as long as you are not challenging the structural violence, then you cannot say that there is peace. Tanu se sense ra ame kahi pariba kono, the absence of war is not peace. Tamane society re war chaluni. But there is a war inside us. We are not happy. We are struggling with our life. So we are not at war, but certainly we are also not in peace. So for marginalized people, equality means overcoming obstacles related to discrimination. Equal opportunities allow people to develop their talents and skill to make them fit, participate in developmental processes. So positive peace demands certain kind of positive discrimination. A positive peace demands certain kind of equal opportunity. Positive peace demands enabling those who are unable, enabling the disabled people. When I'm saying disabled people, I'm not talking about physical handicap. I'm saying about there are different kinds of disability, there are different kinds of disabled people. However, negative peace thinker argues that it is unrealistic or meaningless to equate peace with social justice. Peace is above than the justice, and justice is a less essential requirement of the peace. Again, go back to that example when Krishna demanded five villages for Pandava. Now, positive theorist mane Krishna ra ei demand ko negate karibe. Positive peace theorist mane se kon kahibe ki if there is no justice, then that peace is superficial. But look at the decision of Lord Krishna. But Krishna took a decision, if you want to maintain justice, then you have to go to the war. And once you are going to the war, then you are facing the destruction. And once you are not there, then what is the meaning of that justice? And that's why justice tharu important hauchi peace. Say point ko peace, a negative peace theorist mane say point ko dharu chanti au se mane kon kahu chanti, peace is above than the justice. Peace is above than the justice. Tanu prathame peace maintain ho. Justice is a less essential requirement of peace. Peace pain, justice ta atyavashyakya gote jinish nuho, right? But without the sense of social justice and equality, ta mane amo society re jodi structural violence rahibo, amo society re jodi inequality rahibo, Tebe, can we think of sustenance of peace? It is a matter to be thought. Amko eta chinta kariba pai padibo ki Mahabharat juddha ku edeiba pai hue to Krishna ei decision te nei thile kintu kon ame sabu situation re ame ei ei Krishna kare ei decision ku ame hold kariba uchit hobo ki ta dwara ame gote status quo to maintain koruche ta dwara to the poor is becoming poorer, the rich is becoming richer. ता माने तो लोकर मेटेरियलिस्टिक एम्बिशन बढ़िबो ता माने तो लोक माने एग्जिस्ट आउ करि परिबे नाही लोक माने पेरिस करि जिवे नाउ विदाउट द कांसेप्ट ऑफ पॉजिटिव जस्टिस कैन नेगेटिव जस्टिस बी मेंटेन्ड और सस्टेन जदि इक्वालिटी नाही आज सिना युद्ध हेनी जदि तमे इक्वालिटी को मेंटेन न कर तबे तमे कोन गारंटी देई परिबो कि आगो को गोटे सिविल वार न होबो बुली ଲୋକମାନେ ଲୋକମାନଙ୍କୁ ଆଟାକ୍ ନ କରିବେ ବୋଲି ତୁମେ କ'ଣ ଏଇଟା କହିପାରିବ ସପୋଜ୍ ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ ଏକ୍ଜାମ୍ପଲ୍ ନେବା ସପୋଜ୍ ନରେନ୍ଦ୍ର ମୋଦି ଗୋଟେ ଡିସିସନ୍ ନେଇଥାନ୍ତେ ଆମେ ଲକ୍ଡାଉନ୍ 5 ମାସ ପାଇଁ କରିବା ଜାଣିଛୁ ସେ ସିଚୁଏସନ୍ କ'ଣ ହେଇଥାନ୍ତା ଲୋକଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର ୟୁନୋ ରିବେଲିୟସ୍ ୟୁନୋ କ୍ୱାଲିଟିଜ୍ ଆସିଥାନ୍ତା ଲୋକମାନେ ରାଜରାସ୍ତାକୁ ଓହ୍ଲେଇ ଆସିଥାନ୍ତେ ଲୋକମାନେ ଭାଓଲେନ୍ସର ୟୁନୋ ଆଶ୍ରୟ ନେଇଥାନ୍ତେ ଲୋକମାନେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରକାରର ସିଭିଲ୍ ୱାର୍ ପର୍ଯ୍ୟନ୍ତ ପଳେଇ ଯାଇଥାନ୍ତେ ଆଜି ବି ଆମେ ଲକ୍ଷ୍ୟ କରୁଛେ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟର ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ କିଛି କାମ କରିଛି ଆଉ କିଛି କାମ କରିପାରିନି ଯେଉଁଥିପାଇଁ କି ଆମର ଭାଇ ଭଉଣୀମାନେ ସେମାନେ ଚାଲି ଚାଲିକା ଆସୁଛନ୍ତି ସୋସିଆଲ ମିଡ଼ିଆରେ ବି ଆମେ ଦେଖୁଛେ ଆଇ ଡୋଣ୍ଟ ନୋ ହ୍ୱେଦର ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ରାଇଟ୍ ଅର୍ ରଙ୍ଗ ଲୋକମାନେ ଏତେ ଭୋକିଲା ଅଛନ୍ତି ସେମାନେ ମଲା କୁକୁରର ମାଂସ ଖାଇ ଦେଉଛନ୍ତି ଲୋକମାନେ ଆସିବା ବେଳେ କେତେବେଳେ ତାଙ୍କର ଦେହାନ୍ତ ଚାଲି ଚାଲିକା ଆସୁଛନ୍ତି ତାଙ୍କର କେତେବେଳେ ଜୀବନ ପଳେଇ ଯାଉଛି ଲୋକମାନଙ୍କର ଛୋଟ ଛୋଟ ପିଲା ସେମାନେ ବି ଆସିବା ଭିତରେ ସେମାନେ ବି ଏ ଗରମରେ ତାଙ୍କର ବି ପ୍ରାଣହାନି ଘଟୁଛି ହେଇଯାଉଛି ନା କେତେ ଦିନ ଆମେ ପିସ୍କୁ ଡିଫାଇନ୍ କରିବା ପିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଆବସେନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଭାଓଲେନ୍ସ ନା ୱିଦାଉଟ୍ ଦି କନ୍ସେପ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ପଜିଟିଭ୍ ପିସ୍ ନେଗେଟିଭ୍ ପିସ୍ ମିନ୍ସ absence of you know violence cannot be maintained so if the study of peace is designed for policy change and action then its ultimate goal is to create social condition for the betterment of life of all humanity so building positive peace should be complementary to the practice of negative peace tano negative peace ko practice kariba uchit kintu ଯଦି ଆମେ ପଜିଟିଭ୍ ପିସ୍କୁ ନେଗେଟିଭ୍ ପିସ୍ରେ ଆମେ ଯଦି ତା'ର ଗୋଟେ କମ୍ପ୍ଲିମେଣ୍ଟାରୀ ଆସ୍ପେକ୍ଟ ଯଦି ଆମେ ତାକୁ ନ ବନେଇବା ଦେନ୍ ଦ ନେଗେଟିଭ୍ ପିସ୍ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ନଟ୍ ସଷ୍ଟେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ସେଲ୍ଫ ସୋ ନେଗେଟିଭ୍ ପିସ୍ ବିକମ୍ ସକ୍ସେସଫୁଲ୍ ଇଫ୍ ଦି କଣ୍ଡିସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ପଜିଟିଭ୍ ପିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅର୍ ଗଟ୍ ସାଟିସ୍ଫାଇଡ୍ ସୋ ଦି ଗୋଲ୍ ଅଫ୍ ପିସ୍ ଆନାଲିଷ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ଟୁ ଡିଟର୍ମାଇନ୍ ହାଉ ଟୁ ମ୍ୟାନେଜ୍ ଅର୍ ରିଜଲ୍ଭ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ in ways that reduce the possibility of violence without dismissing justice and freedom tano jo mane those who are the peace seeker peace keeper semane dita jinsa ku chinta kariba uchit semane negative au positive dita jaka peace ku naba uchit semane violence ku avoid kariba uchit all kinds of violence from physical to non physical and semane justice au freedom ku ଲୋକଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ପହଞ୍ଚାଇବା ମଧ୍ୟ ଉଚିତ ସୋ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଏ ଭାଷ୍ଟ ରେଞ୍ଜେସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ଆପ୍ରୋଚେସ୍ ଅର୍ ଏକ୍ସପେରିମେଣ୍ଟ ଆଟାଚ୍ ଟୁ ଦି ଷ୍ଟଡି ଅଫ୍ ପିସ୍ ଦେର୍ ହିୟର୍ ୱି ୱିଲ୍ ଡିସ୍କସ୍ ଆବାଉଟ୍ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଥ୍ରୀ କାଇଣ୍ଡସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଆପ୍ରୋଚେସ୍ ଟୁ ଦି ପିସ୍ ଦ ଫାଷ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଫେମିନିଷ୍ଟ ଆପ୍ରୋଚ୍ ଦ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ପଲିଟିକାଲ୍ ଇକୋନୋମି ଆପ୍ରୋଚ୍ ଦି ଥାର୍ଡ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଏନ୍ଭାରମେଣ୍ଟାଲ୍ ଆପ୍ରୋଚ୍ ରାଇଟ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ଫେମିନିଷ୍ଟ ଆପ୍ରୋଚ୍ ମୁଁ ବହୁତ ଜିଷ୍ଟରେ ତାକୁ କହିବି right there are you know trains of feminism from liberal feminism to radical feminism there are grand theory grand justification right ek class re ete sabu jinsa kahi hobo nahi but feminist value caring compassion nurturing have enriched the concept of peace ତ ସେମାନେ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ଫେମିନିଷ୍ଟ ମାନେ କ'ଣ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ଫିମେଲ୍ ଆର୍ ଭେରି ମଚ୍ ୟୁନୋ ପିସ୍ ଓରିଏଣ୍ଟେଡ଼୍ ଦେନ୍ ଦି ମେଲ୍ ମାନେ ଫେମିନିଷ୍ଟ କହୁଛନ୍ତି नारी माने शांति प्रिय पुरुष माने शांति प्रिय नुहति काहेकि ना नारी माने क्यारिंग को भैल्यू करती माने नारी माने क्यारिंग भितर गोटे इमोशन अच्छी क्यारिंग अच्छी नारी मान भितर गोटे क्यारिंग एटीट्यूड अच्छी ना से क्यारिंग एटीट्यूड इट लीड्स टुवर्ड्स देयर पीसफुल और पीस बेस्ड पर्सनालिटी नारी माने कंपासन भी था नारी माने नर्चरिंग गोटे एक्चुअली नारी मान जो गोटे गोटे जो अच्छी कौन ए जो चाइल्ड बर्थ जो चाइल्ड बर्थ क्वालिटी ए चाइल्ड बर्थ क्वालिटी रु ही नारी मान भितर ये सब क्वालिटीज गुड़ा आसी था नाउ एवरी मदर केयर्स अबाउट हर चाइल्ड एवरी मदर इज वेरी कंपासनेट टू 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 हर चाइल्ड फॉर द एग्जांपल तुम्हें देख यही गुण पाई भी तुम्हें देख कि वोमेन आर अल्सो द सिंबल ऑफ पैट्रियार्की ता माने देख जनरली सपोज गोटे स्वामीटे स्त्री को ठीक हाथ उठेदे आई समय स्त्रीटा भी स्वामी उपर को रागरे कि गोटे कमटे करदे हाथ उठेदे कि गोटे करदे जोटा को मुझे इट इज ऑपरेशन क्रॉस्ड बाय द कॉन्फ्लिक्ट एवरी फैमिली रे ए प्रकार छोट मोट कॉन्फ्लिक्ट थाए बट ताकू आमे गोटे अति ब्रॉडर आकार नहीं कि मैनिपुलेशन आड़ को नवा उचित नुह बट फैमिली भितर ये सब जिन होता है बाय सेइंग दैट आई एम नॉट जस्टिफाइंग इट बट व्हाट आई एम सेइंग दैट इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द ट्रू नेचर ऑफ ह्यूमन रिलेशनशिप देन यू आर गोइंग टू मेक ह्यूमन रिलेशन एज ए मैटर ऑफ लीगल डिस्कोर्स देन ए मैटर ऑफ सोशल डिस्कोर्स You need to think about whether to convert your relation into legal or into social. It's a different, matter. You need to think about it. But let's come to that example. जो जत्ते वाले तंग भीतर झगड़ा टे चलची, सत्ते वाले पुओ रो माटे ऐसी की, सीए तार पुओ को सपोर्ट करुँची. कहें कि ना ता पुओ प्रति तार गुटे केयरिंग रही जायची, ता पुओ प्रति तार गुटे क्षमा भावना रही जायची. ता पुओ प्रति ता भी ता गोटे ताकू से नर्चर करछी ना तार से पुओ को नर्चर करछी ना तेणु से तार पुओ को क्षमा करछी ता पुओ प्रति केयर करछी सेते बेले से गोटे बहु को कौन लगुची ना मो सासु होची ही इज द सिंबल ऑफ सासु सासु बहुटे सासु को कहुची यू आर द सिंबल ऑफ पैट्रियार्की ता माने सठी सासु माने दे आर एंटी फेमिनिस्ट किंतु से फेमिनिस्ट माने सासु को भी इनक्लूड एठी करउचंती व्हेन दे आर सेइंग दैट फीमेल्स आर केयरिंग फीमेल्स आर हैविंग कंपासन एटीट्यूड कंपासनेट गुण अच्छी तांको पाखरे दे आर नर्चरिंग सो द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ फेमिनाइन वैल्यूज दीज आर द फेमिनाइन वैल्यूज नॉट मास्कुलाइन वैल्यूज द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ फेमिनाइन वैल्यूज to the radical transformation of an oppressive social order serves as an important principle in the struggle for achieving the peace to se mane kon kahuchanti if you want the transformation of oppressive social structure you cannot change it with your radicalism rather than you can change it through the feminine values through the caring value through the compassion value through the nurturing value then only you can bring a transformation of an oppressive social structure in a true sense it cannot happen in a legalistic framework law dwara kebe konosi jinsa samadhan nei ni hain sada bele kon if you remember every common individual कौनसी भी गोटे साधारण लोक कहे आई विल सी यू इन द कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ नाउ लॉ इज अ मैटर ऑफ चैलेंज सो व्हेन समबडी इज गोइंग अगेंस्ट मी इन द लॉ देन आई ऑलवेज सी दैट पर्सन एज ए एनिमी एंड एज लॉन्ग एज आई सी दैट पर्सन एज एन एनिमी देन आई एम एडिंग टू दैट ऑप्रेसिव सोशल स्ट्रक्चर आई एम जस्टिफाइंग दैट ऑप्रेसिव सोशल स्ट्रक्चर सो वुमेन आर इन अ बेटर पोजिशन देन मेन to appreciate the values of peace they have played the role of natural peace maker throughout most of the history of human civilization tano gote sense ra me kahi pariba from the beginning of human civilization women are the first peacekeeper women are the first peacemaker It is the women that control the aggressive qualities of a man, right? So men are basically controlled by the female. For example, a mother has the power to control the aggressiveness of her son. A wife has the controlling power over the husband. A wife can reduce the aggressive power of her husband. A daughter can reduce the aggressive power of a father. I mean, if I'm angry on my wife, and if my daughter comes before me, and it has happened many times, more rago thonda hai, I don't know how. Now they are from the very beginning of human civilization. The women are the first peacemaker, and they are the first peacekeeper. The feminine notion of peace exposes the hierarchical nature of our society, superior and inferior relationship between certain members, the elimination of violence in both private and public sphere is essential to achieve or to for achieving peace. Then feminist man karo jo mula tankar thila kona na, there is a gender based violence. There is a gender based violence in the private and public. And feminist man karo gote greater slogan kona, they don't believe in the distinction between the private and public. For them, private is public, public is private. What they are saying, as long as you are not eliminating the violence in the private and public sphere, then you cannot establish the peace. Tanu tamku ba amamanku say equality ko aniba pai padibo, amanku justice aniba pai padibo, amanku wisdom aniba pai padibo. Now equality, I'm not saying equality as a form of right. I'm saying equality as a form of duty. I have the duty to maintain the equality. I have the duty to achieve the wisdom. I have the duty to maintain the justice in the system. It's not as a right. I'm saying all these in the sense of duty. So feminist conception of peace are extended to the condition of social justice, economic equality, ecological balance. Generally, jo mane feminist hai thanti, se mane environmentalist bhi hai thanti. Karana ecology ba environment ko ame maa sahito tulana kari tha. Right? Environment, ame jatala environment re hi ba si lekhu, ame environment ko si lekhi thau, hi lekhi na thau. ताको क्लिबलिंग ईट भी करी था, बट एनवायरनमेंट को मास सहित तुलना करा जाए तेणु जेहेतु फेमिनिस्ट माने दे टॉक अबाउट वुमेन दे आर आल्सो इकोलॉजिस्ट दे आल्सो वांट टू प्रोटेक्ट द एनवायरनमेंट कहीं ना जब चलुची एनवायरनमेंट सहित कहार झगड़ा चलता है इफ यू रिमेम्बर द ग्रीन पॉलिटिक्स इन ग्रीन पॉलिटिक्स दैट इज ए क्राइसिस बिटवीन द एनवायरनमेंटलिस्ट एंड developmentalist, right? So feminist माने developmentalist को support करने, environment को support करने. The second approach of peace is the political economic approach. So this approach examines the nature of modern political economy and its implication for conflict, right? You can take Marxism, right? हमें तो लगा कुछ political economic approach. We talks about the Marxian approach to the peace. So to it, conflict happens due to economic disparities between rich and poor. Tamane, if there is no equality, there is inequality, there are disparities between the rich and poor, then conflict it is a obvious obvious phenomenon. So only by producing opportunities for marginalized people and narrowing down the gap between the rich and poor, the conflicts can be dismantled. Eta Marx bhi sei katha kahuchani. Se kahuchani kahana na garibo loko, marginalized, broken men, anko manko pai kichi opportunities create karajibo, aur chesta karajibo, core aur periphery bhitre, ete difference jemti na rahibo. Rich aur poor bhitre, jodi difference ku ame ಟಿಕೆ ಕಮೈಲು ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಯುನೋ ರಿಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ರಿಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪುವರ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಮಂಟಲಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್ ಕೈನಾ ಕಾನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಇಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಸೊ ದಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಂಟಾಗೋನಿಸಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಸರ್ವ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿ ಅಚೀವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ದಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋಯಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ರಿಲೇಶನ್ಶಿಪ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿ ಕಲ್ಮಾಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ವೆದರ್ ಎವೇ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ವೆದರ್ ಎವೇ ಕರಿಬ ಡಿಕ್ಟಾಟರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೊಲಿಟೇರಿಯನ್ ತನು ದ ಡಿಕ್ಟಾಟರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೊಲಿಟೇರಿಯಟ್ ಏಟಾ ಕೇವಲ ಕಿಛಿ ದಿನ ಪೈ ರಹಿಬ ಕಾಹಿಕಿ ಕಿಛಿ ದಿನ ಪೈ ರಹಿಬ ನಾ ವೆನ್ ದ ಸೋಸೈಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್ ದೆನ್ ದೇರ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಯು ನೋ ಸಮ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ದೇ ಮೇ ಡು ಕೌಂಟರ್ ರಿವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ರಿವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಕೌಂಟರ್ ರಿವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಬುರ್ಜುವಾ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟು 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 ಯು ನೋ ಚೆಕ್ ದಟ್ ಕೌಂಟರ್ ರಿವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಲಿಟರಿಯನ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ must be there dictatorship of the but once the counter revolution is disappear then automatically the dictatorship of the proletariat as a form of state it will wither away and equality can be maintained so this is all about your you know how to maintain peace this is all about your you know political economic approach or Marxian approach to bring peace there is environmental approach so this approach points out that unbalanced relation between the human and bio environmental system is a source of threat to human survival it can damage the life support system of all sphere ethi di ta kotha ame dekhuche jodi ame prakruti pakharu kom jinsa nouche if we derive small things from the you know environment then prakrutir koral rupa amku ame seta ko face kari boli we will not face the negative you know negative side of the environment jonta actually aji ame face karuchu aji ame look at your environment today you will feel that somewhere ame environment ko ete bhabe aji environment it taking a violent roop gote violent roop environment nauchi and we are facing the problem in our existential bele bele laguchi jemti entire human existence nashta heijibo tenu either tame jodi environment pakaru besi jinsa tame jodi naucha tebe bi environment is becoming violent and there is a problem to your existence there is a problem to your peace eita gote ଯଦି ତମେ ଏନଭାରମେଣ୍ଟ ପାଖରୁ କମ୍ ଜିନିଷ ନଉଛ ଦେନ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ସ୍କାର୍ସିଟି ଅଫ୍ ରିସୋର୍ସେସ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ୱେନ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ସ୍କାର୍ସିଟି ଅଫ୍ ରିସୋର୍ସେସ୍ ଦେନ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରଗଲ୍ ଫର୍ ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ୱେନ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରଗଲ୍ ଫର୍ ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ଦେନ୍ ମାଇ ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ୱିଲ୍ ବି ଏ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ଫର୍ ୟୋର୍ ଏକ୍ଜିଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ ବିକଜ୍ ରିସୋର୍ସେସ୍ ଆର୍ ଭେରି ଫ୍ୟୁ ଦେନ୍ ଦ ନମ୍ବର୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ରିସୋର୍ସେସ୍ ଆମ ପାଖରେ ଅଳ୍ପ ଅଛି ନା ସେ ଅଳ୍ପ ରିସୋର୍ସକୁ ହୁ ୱିଲ୍ accumulate that wealth right kie accumulate je market ro dali kom achi chaulo kom achi tenu je se dali chaulo kini parla se banchibo je no kini parla se mari jibo tenu environment pakru jodi ame adhika bi nouche tebe bi gote prakar ro peace upare effect peace is getting affected jodi environment ପାଖରୁ ଆମେ କମ୍ ବି ନଉଛେ ଆଣ୍ଡ ପିସ୍ ଗଟ୍ ଏଫେକ୍ଟେଡ୍ ତ ଦି ସ୍କାର୍ସିଟି ଅଫ୍ ଏନଭାରମେଣ୍ଟାଲ ରିସୋର୍ସେସ୍ ଏଜ୍ ଏ ସୋର୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଭାଓଲେଣ୍ଟ କନ୍ଫ୍ଲିକ୍ଟ ପିସ୍ ଅନ୍ ଦି ଆର୍ଥ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ନଟ୍ ବି ରିଏଲାଇଜ୍ ୱିଦାଉଟ୍ ଇକୋଲୋଜିକାଲ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ତା ମାନେ କ'ଣ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ପଡ଼ିବ ଯେଉଁଟା ଆମେ କହୁଛେ ଜଳ ବିହୁନ ସୃଷ୍ଟି ନାଶ ଜଳ ବହୁଳେ ସୃଷ୍ଟି ନାଶ ତେଣୁ ଜଳ ଯଦି ନ ହେଲା ମରୁଡ଼ି ପଡ଼ିଗଲା ଜଳ ଯଦି ଅଧିକା ହେଲା ବନ୍ୟା ଯଦି ହେଇଗଲା ତେବେ ବି ଦୁନିଆ ନଷ୍ଟ ହେଇଯିବ ତେଣୁ ଏନଭାରମେଣ୍ଟ ପାଖରୁ ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ କୌଣସି ଜିନିଷ ବି ଆମେ ନଉଛେ ୱି ସୁଡ୍ ଅଲସୋ ପେ ବ୍ୟାକ୍ ଟୁ ଦି ଏନଭାରମେଣ୍ଟ ନା ଆର୍ ୱି ଡୁଇଂ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ପେଇଂ ବ୍ୟାକ୍ ଟୁ ଦି ଏନଭାରମେଣ୍ଟ ତେଣୁ ଆମେ ଏନଭାରମେଣ୍ଟ ପାଖରୁ କମ୍ ନବାନି ଆମେ ଏନଭାରମେଣ୍ଟ ପାଖରୁ ଆମର ନିଡ୍ ମୁତାବକ ନବା ଆମ ଗ୍ରିଡ୍ ମୁତାବକ ନୁହଁ पुणी जेतोला आमे एनवायरनमेंट पाखरु नीड मुताबक किछि जिंस नउचे आमे एनवायरनमेंट को किछि जिंस दबा मध्यमे दरकार टू मेंटेन द बैलेंस बिटवीन द ह्यूमन एक्जिस्टेंस बायोलॉजिकल एक्जिस्टेंस एंड एनवायरनमेंटल एक्जिस्टेंस. सो एज लॉन्ग एज यू मेंटेन दैट बैलेंस बिटवीन द एनवायरनमेंट एंड द ह्यूमन एक्जिस्टेंस देन यू can you come to the concluding part? What is the relation between the peace or with state and the society? Here, if you remember the Gramscian understanding of, I'm using Gramsci here because he is quite relevant in this context, and I can think that Gramsci, in certain sense, we can say that Gramsci is also a theorist of peace. A theorist of peace, because for Gramsci, the function of civil society is to build the consensus, and when there is a building of consensus, then you are actually trying for peace, because consensus is revolved around peace. If society, consensus hele peace haba, peace hele consensus hai paribo. So the relation between the consensus and peace is very much dialectical. They are very much complementary to each other. Even the function of the state, jonda Gramsci kahutile, there are two kinds of function for the state. One is the coercive function and one is the consensus building function. तेणु स्टेट्र काम नुह केवल कोहेरसन को एप्लाय करवा स्टेट्र काम हूँ कनसेनसस को बिल्डअप करवा आम कहीपर स्टेट इज इक्वल टू सिविल सोसाइटी प्लस तेणु स्टेट्र काम हूँ कनसेनसस बिल्डअप कर पीस को मेन्टेन कर एंड दैट्स दि फंक्शन ऑफ दि स्टेट. सो इन दि मटेरियल राइट जोटा तुम मेरे अच्छी इफ यू विल गो थ्रू दैट मटेरियल the total elaboration is there. I think you need to read, you need to understand ki how the state is becoming as an instrument of maintaining and sustaining a peace, how civil society maintain and sustain the peace. So it is something, it depends on your reading. So in one lecture, I thought of that I will not speak to you because there are many interesting points. I was thinking that I will make those points and making it reach to you, and the rest I think that you can read, you can understand, and if there is any problem you can also ask me. So thank you very much, Antarjami.
Okay, thank you sir, thank you so much for your enlightened lecture session on this particular topic, the peace and conflict studies and nature and scope and conceptual analysis of peace and conflict studies. As you clearly mentioned and clearly discuss and clearly highlight the points which really relevant in the contemporary time, and also you provided a good example from the mythic, from the Mahabharata or Ramayana, or from the family structure of the Indian context. You also point out some approaches of peace and conflict studies, peace and conflict approaches of peace. You mentioned feminist approaches, environmentalist approaches, and political and economic approaches. So I will not detail everything because we have some questions. So we'll take, I think that is three particular questions, but as you have also mentioned, the first a question which is asked by a student, what is feminist approach to peace? So you have already answered that question, so there is no need to take that question. So the second question I would rather ask you or the read for you is, can economic rivalry between US and China be called as the struggle for their existence? Can economic rivalry between
China and America,
yes, US and China, be called as the struggle for their existence?
Yes.
The second question asked by the Vikas Bindhani, he's asking about what is concept of peace building. let's take two questions because you have already answered another two questions. So let's take two questions. Then if somebody will ask, then we will take another one or two questions.
What is the concept what is the concept
of peace building?
That's a peace building. Second question tare mu actually mu ma talk re peace
mention.
Building katha mu kahi nahi
mention kahi
nahi. I have not mentioned.
I will not
answer the second question, but let me answer the first question. Right. Okay, so we need to understand what is the meaning of existence, right? So existence for what? Existence to sustain, right? Existence to be alive. That is one understanding of existence. But the economic struggle between the China and America, that is also existence, the existence of a nation state, because every nation, from the realist point of view, from the Morgenthau realism, you can understand maximization of national interest. So once you accept the maximization of national interest, and once you accept realism as a guiding principles of nation state, then I think we need to understand the economic struggle is also related with the existence of either China or America. Existence of what? Existing as a superpower. You can say that this is a form of greed, and that's why I always call for, even the international relation, you should rethink about your national interest. You should not follow realism. It's my strong notion, right? I hold it. The more you follow the realism, the more you maximize your national interest, the more you relate your national interest with your existence, then the more you are becoming greedy. And once you are becoming greedy, then you may justify, you may relate it to your existence, but one day you will perish, right? So somewhere, I think ethically or normatively, I don't think that economic struggle between the China and America, it is a struggle for existence. Ethically speaking, I will say that it is a struggle for greediness. But in a real term, in reality, I will say that yes, it is the struggle for existence. And what is the reason of the struggle? Because they want to exist as a superpower. Now, to exist a superpower, you have to struggle. So this is the answer of the first question. And what are the other questions?
Okay. Thank you, sir. There is no more question. There is no more question so far. So let me ask the learner if they want to interact with you. So anybody from the learner side, from the student side, they want to put any question to our speaker, or if they have any doubts, or if they have any queries or any observation, they can share. So I would request all the learners, like one by one, if anybody have any doubts, I can speak with him. So if anybody have any doubts, so please unmute your mic and speak with him. Hello. All the learners are requested to unmute their mic and they can speak with our speaker. If anybody really want to ask any questions or any doubts or any observation. Okay, anyway, nobody is like interested to ask anything. So on behalf of Odisha State Open University, now we are in the concluding part to close this session. So on behalf of Odisha State Open University, I would thank our speaker, Dr. Himanshu Shekhar Mishra, for his time and for his intellect to share with us. He has been teaching on our online class since last 2 months. So we are really grateful, we are really pleasure to have with you, and we'll be contacting with you for the other different classes. So I will be in the touch, and I would also like to thanks all the learner, the students, to have patience in this class, to maintain discipline at least. And also I would like to thanks our technical person, Devashish Barik. He's been kindly supporting us throughout the session since 2 months. I always do prefer to keep Devashish Barik to be my technical person, because he's so much expert to deal everything smoothly, coordinate everything smoothly. So thank you so much to all of you, and thank you, Dr. Himanshu Sekhar Mishra, sir. If any words you want to say, sir?
Thank you very much. You are most welcome. And it's okay. We will talk privately. No problem.
Yes, sir. Sure, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Hello, Devashish. Hello, Devashish.
Sir, kundu.
हाँ ठीक अच्छे तेल सेसन क्लोज कर हाँ देवाशिष आ गए कथ आज के सेसन रेकर्डिंग आसीज एंड को मैं डाउनलोड है सार को पठेदेव
सियोर सियोर सार पठेदेव
हाँ जिते बेले भी हम सन्दे हम कि कल सकाल okay, do you want to say something, Sushanto Prasad?
Yes sir, just I wanted to put a request before you, sir.
Yes sir,
sure. I'm a working person, I'm working, so
yes sir,
sir mo message pause to immediately message file out, sir, attend to difficult he will be, sir, because we are working right now working in the health department, so we are moving for the COVID thing.
Seriously in the university, and we'll really think about on your request. And from our part, what we do is, like, in every day we have 6 sessions in the morning and 6 sessions in the evening, right? 3:30. So
sir,
what we do is because of not to confuse any of the session, what we do is we generate the link in the morning of the day, through which like one session will not overlap with the other session,
sir.
But your point is to be considered. Your point will be taken into seriously, and we'll think about it, and we'll let you know, and we'll try to communicate with you, or we'll try to send the message one day prior, right? So
sir,
thank you for your suggestion, and thank you for your kind observation of the online class, right?
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay.
Actually, it's so kind of you. It was so much enlightening session. Thank you
so much. Okay, then let's close the session, and we will meet soon, hopefully.